time, Friday night, when a group of old broads get together to talk about their week in business. Hope you had a good one too.
Happy Tiffy. Oh, look, there we go. I'm not fading into the background. Happy Tiffy time. I'm Charlie. There's Gail.
It's Friday night.
It's Friday night, and please forgive us if we have been, if we start yawning. I'm like, oh my God, here it goes. Okay, sorry, and I'll wait for Gail because it's really been contagious this evening. We have been having a chat before I turned record on. But yes, please forgive us if we do yawn a little. It's not that anything is particularly boring, it is just that we are really busy lately. And we're still
super busy.
Super busy, which is absolutely fantastic. Exactly where you want to be when you're running a business. I've got enough coming through my pipeline too that I'm not too worried about. You know, I'm busy now. Am I going to be busy in 6 weeks? Which is always something a small business owner has to worry about. And apart from, you know, but just being super busy, we both still are. We're on the mend, but we still have been a little bit under the weather and just making sure that we practice a little bit of self-love.
Our bounce back isn't quite as quick as it used to be.
Oh, God, no. What bounce back? I think I went splat.
But I think as younger women, you got sick and you just recovered and got on with it. Now it's like, you know, 3-4 weeks later, you're still getting on with it, but at a much slower pace. And it's like, oh, yes, it's 7 o'clock. Oh, God, it's bedtime.
Yeah. I'm going to knock off here and go and have something to eat and go to bed because that's what I want to do because that's a good time for me. So there's a couple of things there actually I wanted to just sort of hit on. And one we'll come back to, and one that is about, yes, we know it's been a couple of weeks since we've actually published a Tiffy Time, and I'm not going to apologise that we haven't. We will explain why we're not going to apologise. But the second one, which you said, you know, as younger women, we did bounce back and we just kept on going. I do sometimes wonder whether the punishment we put ourselves through as younger women just to try and keep things going and keep everything running and burning the candle at both ends, or in some cases three places because you've got family, you've got work, and you've got yourself you're trying to look after, actually has an effect on us now because I was actually saying it out, I've got no resilience. There's nothing there. I get sick and I get sick.
Mm. And you go down, don't you? Like go down majorly.
Yeah. Yeah, so if you are part of our younger audience, and I do hope we have a younger audience watching and listening to us, take on board, please, that us as mature women, I'll say that, are telling you that you really need to take some time out and take some time for yourself and discover what is important to you, and that's what you do. Don't try and do it all. Discover what's important to you and focus on that, which kind of brings us into why we haven't had an episode in a month, really, or maybe nearly close to 2 months now, a month and a half. And I'm going to let you start on that one, Gail.
I think with both of us having been quite ill, it very much is at the end of the week, I just want to pour myself into bed. You just don't have the energy left over to, this is the first time we've met and talked in 6 weeks. So, you know, we used to be really good and meet every second Friday. But I guess now we're tired of come Friday, and it's like, I've not got the energy to do this. So I'm going to bed. So
pretty much, and yeah, we were talking about that, and both of us kind of went, okay, so we haven't got an episode out in 6 weeks. Gee, aren't we bad? And I stopped and said, no, actually, we're not bad, because what we've done is said what is important to us. Our health is important to us. Yes, we love doing this podcast. Yes, we love having a chat every second Friday night. But it was something that we could both afford to let slide for a little bit while we worked on ourselves and while we looked after ourselves and got ourselves back up to fighting speed. And
ooh, we're still working on that.
Quite sure we are yet. We should get another episode out in a fortnight, but we will see. But yeah, more importantly, what I haven't done, which is something I would normally have done, is beat myself up for not having everything done. And not, oh, I didn't get my podcast out and I didn't do this and I didn't do that and I didn't do the next thing. And I've gone, you know what? I got all these other things done and my health is here. I'm rebuilding my health and I'm actually starting to feel better. And that is such a nice place to be.
Self-compassion and love and you know, like I'm important within this world to an awful lot of people. So my health needs to be up there too.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And as I said, as much as we love doing this podcast and as much as I had been enjoying getting out and walking and taking the dog for a walk, I went, I'm not ready for that yet. I'm not going to do that because I know if I go out, I'm just going to knock myself up terribly and be, and I'll just slide back and I'll be sick again. I'll just take it a little slower. Take it a little slower means I go for shorter walks or I go and, you know, do something else for a little bit. So that's really important. And I'm just going to say I'm going to give myself a gold star because I can give myself a gold star, but I am going to give myself a gold star for not stressing and not, what's that term, sweating the small stuff.
And looking after ourselves. I mean, it's been a long, hard ride to get here. So to actually be able to sit here and now have that compassion for ourselves, I think is really important. I think it's worth two gold stars.
Thank you. Well, you can have two too. I'll give you two gold stars.
We'll share the gold stars.
So I'd really be interested to hear what our audience has to say and what people who are listening to this at a later date have to say. Talk about, you know, how do you feel? When you look at the end of the week and think, I haven't got all these things. I've got all these things I didn't achieve. Is that what you're focusing on, or are you looking and saying, I achieved all these things and these other things, they didn't quite make the priority, so I didn't quite make them? Because that would be of interest to me.
And it'd be interesting to know how people handle that too and what strategies they have or what strategies they use to make it happen, because I don't know that we always have the answers as older, mature as we are. My to-do list just rolls over to the next day. So you just seem to catch up and a couple of hours on the weekend, and as long as I'm all clear to start Monday, we'll be fine. But I just wonder what other strategies people have about coping with it and letting it go and not
maybe you're not in business for yourself, or maybe you're just starting out, or maybe, you know, you work for someone and you've got a really, I'm not going to say stressful, well, I will say stressful, but not in a bad way, a stressful, demanding job. How do you cope with it? Gail said her to-do list just rolls over. My to-do list is never finished. I've always got things on my to-do list. And you know what? That's great, because that gives me something to get out of bed for the next day. I'm not worried that I'm going to get out of bed and go, what am I doing today? I've got nothing to do. I will always have something to do. And if I finished all of the things that I needed to do for customers, there are still things I can do for myself. I can do things on my website. I can go and, honestly, I can go and do the cleaning.
Books to be read, movies to be watched, and I have that new
Walking to be done. Excellent. Is that out? Is that new Dungeons and Dragon movie out yet?
I think it's coming out, I heard, next week, so it's kind of on my hit list.
Oh, I so want to go. I love the shorts for that. I so want to go see. I'm not disappointed. I'm sorry. What were we saying about Dungeons and Dragons?
Yes. Look, see, here we go.
My wolf and my dragon.
I saw the shorts taught at the movies when I took the kids in to see the Avengers the other week, and the shorts were just fantastic. Like
I saw one of my friends shared it with me on via Discord. I think it was on Apple TV, maybe they had the shorts for it, and she shared it, and I'm like, oh, I so want to see it. I think my comment was, I hope the movie is as good as the shorts.
Yeah. And there's also, oh, now I've got my movies confused. One coming out with Lucy Liu and Helen Mirren.
I don't know.
Shazam.
Are they in Shazam, are they?
I think they're in the second one, and I might have it wrong, but gosh, it looked good. And
I haven't seen the first one, and I've got to say I'm such a comic nerd that I haven't really liked what they've done with the movies, but that's me. And honestly, if people can go and watch them and have a great time, go and do it. Absolutely go and do it.
I saw the shorts of that at the same movie, and I just looked at that. You know when you walk away from a movie and you go, I want to see this and this and this and this, and it's like, oh, there's me done for the next 6 months.
I used to sit there with my phone, and as the shorts would come up, like, this one, no, keep away from this one. And I'd always come away with a little short list. Mm. The other movie I want to see that's coming out is Tetris. I don't know if you've seen the shorts for that.
No.
I will find it and I will share it with you. But so you're thinking, oh, Tetris, a movie about Tetris? I saw it and I thought, I got to say, when I saw the title of it, I thought, oh, my goodness. So we finally got there. We've run out of things to make movies about. Right? Am I wrong? Is this not what you thought when I said there's a movie coming out about Tetris? It's actually about the guy who got the licensing rights from Russia at, I'm not sure it was the peak of the Cold War, but it was during the Cold War, to put Tetris on the first, not PlayStation, one of the first consoles. And
Tetris,
it's about this
was on Nintendo.
I think it was, yeah, it was on a Nintendo, but I don't know which one. Or was it an Atari? No, it might have been on the Atari. But they packaged this console with Tetris, apparently. I haven't checked the history on it, but the story is that it was done by a Russian developer. So Russia, not the developer themselves, but Russia themselves owned.
What did Mario come out on first?
I would have been a Nintendo. That would have been
No.
He was a Nintendo. He was absolutely a Nintendo.
We had something before Nintendo, and I'm sure we had Mario on that one.
You sure it's not an Atari? Now you're going to make me go and look it up. I'm just pulling up a browser over here on my other screen. Tetris is one that I think I really want. I really want to watch it. The shorts really pulled me in. It looks like it's a great movie. And I've got to say, yeah, I went, we finally got there. Hollywood's finally run out of things to tell movies and make movies
never.
About. And I got to the end of the short and went, I'm happy to say I'm wrong. What console was
a 1990 game console would have been
released on. There we go. Oh, it was the NES. It was one of the, it was a Nintendo.
I was
Super
actually
Mario.
Thinking of, I was thinking of the Sega, actually.
Oh.
I just remember my kids had a Sega. That's what we got first.
Yeah, I'm gonna. I consoles and Segas. I'm not a console girl.
Oh,
okay. I'm not gonna do it while we're recording. I'll look later.
Yeah, we will.
Yeah. So I'm as much as I'm a bit of a geek, consoles are not my thing. Never really owned a console. Oh, I did. I owned that. I owned that one of the original consoles that you played Pong on, with the little joysticks with the swirly tops on them. You don't remember that console?
No.
I think the only thing we could play on it was Pong, and we'd set it up, and to move the bars up and down the screen, you would take a little hand controller, which was about this big, and you'd just hold it in the hand, and you would twist the knob on the top of it, and we'd go up and down. And I used to get it at a point where I could get the ball, the ball, and it would hit my paddle, and it would hit the thing, and it would hit my paddle, and it would just keep going. That's the only console I've really owned.
Oh, I think we've had Sega was the first one, and then we had Nintendo. I think then we went to Nintendo. Then we had a 64. And then
I've been a PC girl all the way through. My dad bought home an 8086. Or was it a 286? Did he bring home a 2? Oh, he might have brought home a 286, which was the AT computer. And I'd been putting 8086s and XTs out on people's desks at work. And he brought home this AT, and they would go to bed and I would play Digger all night. And then I'd get up in the morning and my hands would be sore because you'd use your keyboard because there was a nanny mouse.
We played, I'm just trying to think, 88 comes to mind, 89. We played a Dungeons and Dragons game and we were in the catacombs and we actually had to get graph paper and map it because there was no lights down there and you'd get down and get lost and end up dead.
Was it a graphics game or was it a text-based game?
It was graphics. You could see it.
Okay. Yeah, no, I don't remember it. But so I mean, about those times I was playing Zork as a text-based game. And Baldur's Gate and Pool of Radiance. And
yeah.
Such a nerd. And I've never owned a console. Fun. Go figure.
No, these were on computer, so.
Yeah. I don't know which one it was you were playing, but there were a couple. And I think if I had to have got graph paper out to map it, I probably wouldn't have done it because me and maps, we're not friends.
We mapped out the whole catacombs. Took us months, absolute months to map out the catacombs.
That's so good though. I mean, yeah, this is why it's a good learning experience. So there you go. Look, we just spoke about a couple of things that really float our boats and things that make us feel good. And things that we would go and do and we wouldn't feel bad about doing it. Wouldn't feel bad about spending that time and not doing some of the other things that we should be doing because, oh, we need to do this if we want to be successful. Because sometimes success is just really about enjoying what you've got at that point in time.
I think success is also about the journey. It's not about just getting there.
Yeah, it's okay. No, I agree entirely. Absolutely. I mean, the destination's nice, but I've got to say I enjoy the journey more often than not. I don't know how many times I've got to a place where I've been aiming and gone, is this it? What's next?
Yeah. Yes, and sometimes I don't think we sit there long enough before we're actually going, right, what's around that corner?
Yes.
So, but I think the journey is important and I think that taking the time out to be sick and to enjoy the journey is really important.
Yeah, yeah, and I'm not saying don't. Gail is not saying, really, she is not saying enjoy being sick because.
No, not at all.
No, but. Do have a listen if you are sick. Do have a listen to what's going on around you and what's happening within you and say, well, what am I missing? Why am I sick? What do I need to take into consideration? It works really well. So whilst we do apologise for not having an episode recently, we are feeling so much better in ourselves for it. And we actually feel like we can be talking to people.
And you're not hanging out for the end of the day so you can pour yourself in bed. It's like, oh.
I tell you what, I was telling Gail just before we sort of came on this on to do the recording. I still live at the golf course. Can't see myself moving on from here anytime soon. It is kind of nice.
Yeah. It is nice.
But we had 130 kids come through and run their cross country on the golf course. So I've been spending all day with a couple of others doing lunches and selling drinks and doing all the things around managing the club so that the kids could have a great day. And I really, really should do a shout out. Ravenshoe State School. Try and say that 10 times fast. Kids were fantastically well behaved and so polite, so many good manners. It was so nice to see. I mean, given that I've seen some kids that sort of they come in and they'd come up to the bar, not that they were buying drinks, they were buying soft drinks and stuff from the bar. And normally, often I'd get them and they'd come up, I'm sorry, I didn't understand you. What was that you wanted? No, not with these kids. They all spoke well, and all of them said please and thank you.
That's really good.
And may I have, and it was so nice. Yeah. It was like, and they really responded to, you know, when you say, thank you so much for being so polite. I'm really pleased to see you're using your manners. And they're like, oh, thank you.
It's nice they get the feedback too.
Absolutely. And I actually went and spoke to a couple of their teachers and we said, we just wanted to say we're really impressed with your kids.
That's
really,
lovely.
Really impressed with the kids. And they're like, oh, thank you. It's such good feedback. Yeah, we thought you'd like that.
Yeah.
And, you know, I was thinking, oh, we're going to have to get out and clean up after they've all been, you know, pick up the rubbish and all done. They've picked up all their rubbish. They've cleaned up everything. There's not a thing left around. The worst I have is the carpet has got grass tracked all over it.
Kids do that.
Oh, you know, we're looking at it and it's like, look at the carpet, like, it is only grass, and you couldn't ask them to fix that because they couldn't do it. So, yes, so I think I've had a couple of exciting things happen in the last couple of weeks, haven't I? Picked up a new resellership. I'm very excited. I'm just finishing my certification. Well, I'm trying to finish my certification training. Not that I have to actually finish the certification training to be able to do the selling, but they do want me to have the certification as I go forward, which is to sell, would you believe, digital phone systems or digital communication systems. It's a digital PABX that has got live chat and video conferencing all built in, and we're just setting up our system now to test it out, aren't we, Gail?
It's really exciting, actually. I think I've been doing virtual assistant now in reception for, I suppose, 6-7 months. Oh no, I've been with Bruce's 12 months. So I guess
I'm going to say you've been with me for longer than that.
Yeah,
and you were doing this with other people as well. So.
And I just think it's becoming so much more popular. And I know when I started with my favourite plumber in Melbourne, you know, we just kind of thought that, I don't really know what we thought, but now we're kind of up to like 20 hours a week and we're hectic and we're busy and you know, it's so exciting. But it's that reception and customer service that you're able to give that people actually keep coming back. So good phone systems are so good.
Yeah, and I mean that's the important thing is you've got to have the tools
that
you rely on and you know that they're just going to work when you need them to work. I spent a long time doing my research before I actually approached this particular company and said, I actually went to them and said, I want to buy a system. I need to replace what I've got in place because it's not working for me anymore. It's just not happening. And I spoke to the guys and they said, okay, so we'd like you to sign up as a reseller. Okay. Sure, I can do
Yeah.
that. it's kind of nice to know that my toolkit is growing as well, like, and it's growing strategically. But you said something there about, the virtual reception is growing. I was actually explaining to someone here in the community that I live in what it is we do, and what it is this part of my team does. And they're like, so what? They take phone calls. I'm like, well, no, they do more than that actually. Because I was thinking also of Katie with her client down in Albany, her hairdressing client or her barber client.
A barber.
You guys take the calls. You don't just answer the calls and take a message. You check calendars, you book people in, you check the status of things. You check in with the business owner or the principal or whoever it is to get an answer back, and you follow through with that. You are so much more than just a receptionist. And when I was explaining that to this person, they're like, really? I'm like, yeah. So when you're ready to put on a reception and you need someone to be answering your phones, but you don't want someone 24, 8 hours a day, 5 days a week. That's what my guys do. And they will charge you for the time they spend, not all the time they're sitting around doing nothing.
No.
That's
No. But it can be as little as 5 hours a week, or it can be, well, we're up to 20 now, and if he gets much more busier,
we're going to have to put on someone else,
we will have to. We'll have to
which
work
is
out.
ex so exciting.
I know. It is exciting. And I think that too, we've also taken on someone else. So I now have two electricians. No, yeah, two electricians and a plumber. So, which is exciting. But so the
You
other
need a chippy to
electrician,
go with
yeah, no, I
that.
need a chippy and a bricky.
You need a chippy and a bricky.
But it's just interesting in the differences in the businesses and how different business models work, and I think people need to look at where their jobs come from too, because not all jobs come from your phone. They also come from your email. So being up, so having someone monitoring your email throughout the day, so that when the job does come in, you actually get it in scheduled, you get back to the person, and it's all scheduled, ready to go. So.
Absolutely. And people will people hate picking up phones and making phone calls.
And if
We're
you
not the
don't,
only ones that hate making phone
no, but
calls.
if people are looking for a tradie, they pretty much, if you can get them on the call, you can get them scheduled and booked in.
Yeah.
And
And the
if you
thing
don't
is,
answer, they've gone somewhere else already and you've lost them.
well, that's because their need is immediate. Generally, if
Yeah.
they're looking for a tradesperson, their need is immediate. Something is broken or something needs, well, not repairing, but something needs extending, and they want it done, and they want it done now because they've finally made that decision. Now, that doesn't mean to say you necessarily have to get them in the next day or so, but you do need to be speaking to them. You do need to give them the feedback that you're there. And then your tradie themselves actually need to follow through on that,
And I'm
go and
lucky,
do the job.
I've got really good tradies. So if I schedule them in, and even when I get a little bit carried away and I send them to a few too many places in one day, they actually follow it through.
Or you just make the phone call and say, look, I'm really sorry, we've been held up. We're going to push you to tomorrow, and you do that early. But that's a big thing with your tradies, means a lot of them do get overwhelmed.
Yes.
I come from a tradies family, I know. I grew up with it. I grew up with it. I was married to it, and I have a son who's a tradie.
And it's easy to get overwhelmed with it because there is this huge need. And when you've got people who don't have water, or they don't have hot water, or they have no heating, they're things that people get quite upset about. So, and tradies are tradies because they want to help people. They're in the
Pretty
services,
much, pretty much.
so.
And I mean, I've seen them turn up on site and go, oh, this is going to cost this much, but I think I tell me what it's going to cost me. Don't sell yourself short. Now, don't sting me for it.
And there's that fine line, isn't there? You know, don't overcharge, but, you know, you do a really good job. And I say that to the guys all the time. You do a really good job.
So we hope you've enjoyed this episode of Tiffy Time. I'm Charlie.
I'm Gail. Have a fantastic fortnight.
I'm Gail. That's Gail. Have a fantastic fortnight. And please remember to like and subscribe and to ring the notification bell so that you don't miss future episodes. Happy Tiffy Time, guys.